Yeah, you know, listen, like I told the guys after the game, I mean, it's obviously great to win in this league, and it's hard to win in this league, and there's many ways to win in this league. And, yeah, when you're in the fourth quarter with that type of lead, I mean, it's obviously it's nice to have. A lot of credit to the defense today to get us that lead. You can breathe a little bit, you know, at least halfway through the fourth quarter.
Do you think you guys played well? No. What were the biggest issues for you?
Well, one, the penalties. I mean, you saw on offense how sort of average we played. I mean, you know, we'd take, for instance, a first down run for 8 or 9 and we'd have a holding, or, you know, a pass and have a either give up a sack or, you know, holding, or it just, the penalties just put us in too many long situations today. Second long, third and long. I mean, haven't looked at the stat book yet, but I bet you there was many of those were second long and third and long plays that it's hard to overcome in this league. And that's a good defense. No, don't get me wrong. That's a good defense. It's a good front. No, we didn't play offensively. Didn't play good enough to you know, we got to look at it and make corrections.
What were some of the issues you thought in terms of being able to throw the ball downfield?
Well, number one, again, good pass rush. I mean, it's a really good pass rush. They got good edge rushers, good tackles. You know, we got edged a few times, but, you know, we got to look at the tape. We got to be hard and critical on ourselves. I got to look at it from my standpoint as a play caller and get better.
Were they consistently playing the same kind of coverages?
Yeah, this is, he's a two deep guy, and there were variations of cover two, at the snap. He brought a lot of edge pressure with the corners and safeties, and you know, so it disrupts a little bit, keeps your backs in, things like that. And then he'll switch gears and play single high man and do the same thing. So it's a nice defense. It's a complex defense, but I thought we just didn't do enough, you know, to overcome some of the mistakes that we made.
The games, the stretch you've got coming up, the three on the road, a couple after that against really good teams. What do you and the group have to do to make sure that you knock off, you know, the sloppiness that you had today?
Well, we just got to keep working. You know, it starts when the players come back on Tuesday, and we get a chance to watch this tape. We get to make the corrections with the players and get ready for our next opponent. So, you know, that's the only way we know how to do it, you know, is to come back ready to work this week.
In the past four games, were you ever concerned that pass rush wasn't going to come this year, that it was going to be a tough year?
No, I was never concerned with that. I mean, there's been a lot of talk about Fletch, and he's now coming into his own. He's feeling good and healthy, and you saw today, I think 10 sacks today. He got after them, and I didn't have any worries, you know, moving forward.
So do you think that your team, considering how big a favor you were, your team didn't focus, your team didn't play hard? And if so, do you think that that's an issue?
Well, I know sometimes you can kind of get caught up in that, you know, as players, as coaches. I mean, you get caught up in that, you know. But again, in this league, it's hard to win, and we always focus on us and control what we can control, and you know, we can't make the mistakes and expect to win, you know, each week. This is a team sport, takes all three phases, and sometimes you can get caught up in it, but you know, it's just a matter of just us focusing on us and eliminating the mistakes that we had today to get better and try to just, you know, again, like everybody says, try to just go 1-0 each week.
When you bring a guy back like Orlando, who had been with the team earlier, but you know, he's thrown into a situation like that, did you talk to him at all this week about what would be expected of him, and how did you like to see him come out 2 sacks and a return?
Yeah, no, he understands. He's a veteran player. I didn't have to have any conversations with him, he just kind of fit in and did exactly, what the defense, what Jim dialed up today. It was great to see, you know, the effort that he had. He made some big plays today for us. Obviously, the touchdown there at the end of the game, he'll get better each week.
You coached against him before. What makes him an effective nickel blitzer? Because he's played that role in the past.
Yeah, he's a smart guy. He times up the blitzes. He, you know, sometimes these guys can kind of slither their way through, you know, and get under blocks, and you know, they're quick enough to bend and edge the corner, and this is who he is, you know, and he's a great addition. I'm glad we were able to get him back.
How much the offense been missing Deshaun, and what are your expectations of when he can be back?
Well, you know, obviously, you know, one player can add value, but it's, again, on offense, it's 11 guys, and you know, obviously the opportunity to maybe throw the ball a little bit deeper down the field can add with his speed, you know, a veteran guy. I thought today too, though, our receivers, you know, did some good things. When the ball went up, they did some nice things down the field. We're able to take advantage of things. I thought the tight ends played well. We just got too many mistakes today. We got to clean up.
Two more plays.
What was the plan for Sidney Jones today?
Yeah, he was you know, healthy enough to dress. You know, the only problem was he didn't take a lot of reps during the week, you know, because we were trying to get him to today. You know, he was there as a backup, you know, corner DB, and we'll assess and you know, see where he's at this next week.
So, Kevin Carson Clay, and are you concerned at all about him maybe holding the ball just a tick too long? He was bent back a couple of times today. He's been bent back five or six times this year. Is that maybe the next step in his maturation process?
I thought overall he handled things well, obviously, until I go back and look at it tomorrow. But, you know, we got to do a better job with protection. We got to understand, you know, with the quarterback position too, that you know, it's okay to, you know, either check it down or throw it away from time to time. Just understand that's kind of been what we've done, you know, leading up to this game. But I thought he played tough and he did the things we asked him to do today.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.